Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Today's episode is sponsored in part by Highland Woodworking. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. And also by Lee Valley and Veritas. Visit their website at leevalley.com. Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop podcast. So today's episode is the first of what will probably be several videos coming out where what I'm going to attempt to do is I have a large backlog of some great questions that have come in over the years and of course topic ideas. One thing I've always told myself is we've got to get through these. I know there are many of you who have similar questions because as I have this backlog, I've been going through it and I noticed that there tends to be several of one particular topic that many of you would like to know more about. So what we're going to do is we're going to start working our way through it. Of course, we do have project videos coming up, so we'll sprinkle these in between. And if we actually start getting quite a few of these, maybe we'll make it a regular weekly type of video. But anyway, so let's go ahead and jump into this very first one. Now, this question has come in from Jason, and actually as I'm recording this, I have yet to actually email Jason. So he'll probably get the response. Jason, you'll get the response from the email. And then, of course, this video will be coming out shortly afterwards. Don't be surprised if they both arrive on the same exact day, the way things are going right now. But anyways, though, Jason and many others over the past few years have asked a very similar question, which is about shoulder planes. Now, Jason has in his email, he says, I've never owned one or used one except for the Stanley No. 92, the non-sweetheart version, and a hock kit at my local woodcraft, only for a couple minutes each. Neither was very sharp. Jason then goes on to say, I've seen your video on the hock kit, and that's about my price range, I think. The guys at Woodcraft say that the Sweetheart No. 92 is a completely different animal, and of course, everyone seems to think the Veritas Medium shoulder plane is the cat's meow, but it's twice as much. The conversion to chisel plane is not a selling point for me. What do you think? And by conversion to a chisel plane, he's referring to the No. 92, the Stanley No. 92 actually is a shoulder plane, and then you can undo it, and it comes apart, and it creates a small chisel plane. So what we've done is, over here at the bench, of course, I have the hock kit, like he was talking about, like Jason had mentioned, and I have the Veritas medium shoulder plane also. Let's come over to the bench a little bit and discuss, number one, what we're going to end up using the shoulder plane for, and then number two, my thoughts on them, because I don't have any experience with the Stanley No. 92 other than having seen it, and of course, I have heard from one or two people what they think about it, and I've seen several reviews over the years about it, so I'll just kind of sprinkle that in a little bit, but let me just say that I have no actual experience with it. So anyways, let's come over to the bench. Okay, so over here at the bench, here are my two planes. It's the medium-sized shoulder plane and, of course, the Ron Hock. One thing I have to say when it comes to the shoulder planes is, regardless of which one you choose, what you're doing with these planes is purely finesse work. There is nothing that's going to be hogged out. You're not using these to remove a lot of material. These are, think of these as like really, really fine sandpaper. You're not going to use your finest grits for removing gouges and stuff like that. So there's no reason in the world you should be using these type of planes for such a task. Really, the shoulder planes are like one of those, this is when you're putting your final touches on it just to get your joinery finessed the right way. You just want to take off minute amount of material. Sure, you might have to take a couple extra passes with it, but really when it comes down to it, these are kind of like your fine sandpaper when you think about it. One thing with the hock kit, of course, you can go back and check out the video on this. You can make it look any way you want it to. It's basically just a rectangle, and then you shape it to the whatever works for you. I made it to this one, and this works great for my hands and everything. You might want to just keep it kind of more rectangular so you can hold it in a different way. This particular model has a bevel down blade, and the Veritas medium shoulder plane has a bevel up, and I know for a fact the Sweetheart No. 92, the Stanley No. 92, also is a bevel up. Of course, when we're working end grain, which a lot of our tenons, when we're working the shoulders, they will be end grain. In my opinion, a bevel up works really nice with that. But at the same time, the bevel down here on the hock, I've never had a problem with it yet. As long as the blade is sharp, and as long as you're taking just that fine, really thin shaving from it, It doesn't matter whether it's bevel up or bevel down, you're going to get the same exact result. With the Hock plane, I think one of the nice things with this is, of course, it's a wooden bodied, so that means that there's less of a chance that you're going to be miring up your material that you're working with, again, as we're kind of finessing it and stuff. I've have yet to really have an issue with the metal body one, but I do kind of like the wooden one. I also like the fact that I get feedback as I'm using it. Literally, you can kind of feel where maybe it's kind of sticking a little bit. The metal is a little bit heavier, obviously, and so therefore you don't quite get as much feedback, but still, you feel something. You know when something's going to get stuck. With the metal one, again, with the medium shoulder vise here, and then, of course, like a Sweetheart number 92, the nice thing is, unlike the wooden one here, where you have to just light taps to get the blade in position and kind of finesse it, with this one, you have an adjuster, and the same thing on the number 92. So you can really fine-tune in where you're going to get it. Now, the most important thing, I think, also, and what I really like about the medium shoulder plane here, is the fact that this toe adjusts in and out so that I can increase or decrease the space for the mouth. This is really important because with certain materials, especially stock where the grain's kind of twisting in and out if it's highly figured or something, even when you're kind of working that end grain a little bit, having that mouth closed just a little bit will actually help to minimize the tear out. Of course, the most important thing is to have a nice sharp blade, but being able to move that mouth in and out really will help me to finesse the final cut that I'm going to be getting. Another thing that I like about the shoulder plane here is the fact that the medium shoulder plane is that I have this pistol grip feel to it. The Lee Nielsen version has a very an old style handle where you actually hold it this way and you kind of tuck it under your arm a little bit and you hold it in that position and this is how you work it. Works fantastic. There's no gripe whatsoever with it. I'm familiar with this and this is comfortable for me. And the nice thing is I can use it left or right-handed. It will conform to my hand and I don't have to worry about what I'm doing with it. The Stanley number 92 also has a kind of a pistol grip to it, so you would have a similar result. But I don't know, it's just quite not the same. I know, Jason, you had mentioned, and many of you also, price is a huge thing when it comes down to it. Obviously, the Hock kit, you can get that for a lot cheaper than you can the other ones. Neat thing about it, you get a nice project. You also get to make it your own, and that's really cool. So I highly recommend, if you get an opportunity to, and you're really interested in doing it, the Hock kit is a great buy. No doubt about it. It will work. I've used it, and I get very identical, same results I do with the shoulder plane, the medium shoulder plane here. But I think if you really want to be able to dial in, I can finesse it just a little bit easier on this than I can on that. And that comes down to experience. You mentioned that, and many of you have also, again, going back to the price thing, that the price for the medium shoulder vise from Veritas is so much higher than, say, a Stanley. Excuse me. What it comes down to is quality. Stanley, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that Stanley is crap, but Veritas really, really stands behind their product 100%. If there is any flaw, they will take care of it. There's nothing to worry about. I happen to look at the Woodcraft website, and I happen to look at the Veritas website, and really the only price difference is about $50, at least as of when I'm doing this video. So for $50 extra, you really get a high-quality shoulder vise, a shoulder plane. Have I been saying shoulder vise? You get a shoulder plane that will just work amazingly. With the Stanley number 2, I think, number 92, you can get a plane that will work for you, but you might have to work at getting it set up and getting it finessed a little bit more than this, and that feature being able to take it off and turn it into a chisel plane. I've made a chisel plane. Really, when it comes down to it, if I have a need for something like a chisel plane, I just grab a chisel. So that's not really a big selling point for me. And from what I've seen from other people, it's not a big selling point for them either. So when it comes down to it, these two are my best choices. Again, the Lee Nielsen one, perhaps, that's also a good one. The only thing for me is I don't like the handle. But when it comes to your shoulder plane, don't skimp. Don't skimp at all on it. Get something that is going to work 100%. Even if it means you have to save up a little bit longer, trust me, you'll really appreciate it in the end. All right, so I think that's pretty much going to do it. Hopefully, Jason, we answered your question. And like I said, there have been quite a few other questions regarding shoulder planes, so hopefully we answered those. If you want to leave a comment or maybe you have another question about the shoulder plane or you just want to make fun of the fact that I kept calling it a shoulder vice versus a shoulder plane, I'm positive I've did that more than once. I'll have to go back and watch the footage, obviously. But you know how to get a hold of me. It's at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. Or, of course, you can leave a comment in the show notes at mattsbasementworkshop.com. And we'll go ahead and get that taken care of. If it's a question that I don't know the answer for, well, I have quite a few friends who maybe actually do. So we'll go ahead and get that taken care of. And like I said, I have a backlog of a whole bunch of questions that came in. And I for sure have emailed pretty much all of you back. But it's kind of neat to see what the topics are. So I'll go through those once again, and we'll pick out another topic. In fact, we'll have it next week to keep this going. Because right now I'm finishing up. Let me grab this. This is the project that I am completing currently. It is a mirror frame. It's going to be going on the back of the door in, going into our room, and it's almost finished. In fact, I ended up doing a little glue up tonight. I'm going to be putting the walnut pegs into it coming up pretty soon to help reinforce the actual tenons, and I'm making sure to document all of this so that you'll have a chance to check it out yourself. And like I said, that will be coming up very, very soon. So anyways, though, I am going to say thanks and remind you, of course, to get those questions and comments in, and I will be talking to all of you later. Straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.